9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
You feel the power of love. You feel the power of love. Can you feel it?
We are so glad that you are here at the Power of Love Women's Conference. Our program will continue in 10 minutes.
Hi, thanks for being here at the Power of Love Women's Conference. And I wanted to let you know about some great resources that we've brought with us. Resources that we know could be a real blessing to your life. For one thing, Tonilee and I have been writing Bible studies for the last 10 years. And so we've brought an assortment of those just for you. Our number one seller over all these years that's gone out truly all over the world is the Spiritual Warfare Bible Study. It's 4 lessons, and it is a powerful message that will help you learn how to live in victory. We need to understand the battle, understand what is going on around us, learn the strategies of Satan. I mean, that's kind of a tough topic, but really understanding what he does to get us off track. The third lesson is on our weapons of warfare. One of the most powerful weapons is prayer. Wouldn't it be great to really dig in and know the power of prayer, the armor of God? That's in the lesson. And last, but certainly not least, is how to live in victory. So do not miss your copy of the Spiritual Warfare Bible Study. And you can also get the teaching. Tonilee and I have taught this several times, and we've included a package for you that has an MP3 player of all the teachings, including little earbuds and a cord that connects to your computer where you can download it. Use it as a small group Bible study for your church or any other individual, including yourself. It's a great resource. Check out all of those Bible studies on the table and let us know if you have any questions. We'd love to help you get it started.
Hi, I'm Lisa from specialtiesbylisa.net, and I work with Bobbye and Tonilee. At the back resource table, I have created towels that encourage you. Some of the towels that I have say, "Trust in the Lord with all your heart. There is no fear in love, and for God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power, love, and self-discipline." You can use these in your kitchen or bathroom, anywhere that you want to brighten your day. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Tonilee Adamson, and I'm so excited to share with you a resource that we have on the table right here with us. It's the Ephesians Bible Study, but Bobbye and I have called it Your Identity in Christ. And why did we do that? Because every single chapter you get to learn who you are to the Lord, how much He loves you, how He knows you, how He's given you gifts and a calling to go out and do a work for Him, how much He wants to bless you, and all those negative thoughts we have. When you find out your identity in Christ, it changes your life. So it is a 6th lesson study. It also comes with the teachings that you can get on a jump drive or the MP3 in the back, so you can do it with your friends. We have a limited supply, so if the Lord is tugging your heart, go check it out, because I've got to tell you, this is one of those Bible studies that will change your life.
Hi, my name is Emily Adamson, and I would like to welcome you to the Daily Disciples Power of Love Conference. Daily Disciples is all over Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and Pinterest, and we would love to see you every day online. We'd love for you to pull out your phone right now and follow us on Instagram with the username Daily Disciples. Also, on Facebook, if you search Daily Disciples, you'll find our Facebook page where we post daily devotionals and words of encouragement. We're also on Twitter and Pinterest as well with the same username. See you there!
Feel the power, just feel
The Power of Love Conference begins in just 5 minutes. Please, be seated.
And I am one of the co-founders of Daily Disciples Ministries, and I would like to bring you a message today from 1 Corinthians 3. Paul is talking to the Corinthians, and he says, "But brothers, I could not address you as spiritual people, but as people of the flesh, as infants in Christ. I fed you with milk and not solid food, for you were not ready for it." There are times in our Christian life that we are young and we start out young and we're babes in Christ, and the Lord loves to baby us in that place. But there will come a time that we have to grow up, and you're going to notice that maybe your prayers aren't answered as quickly, or you feel like God isn't with you anymore. It's not true. He's with you. You're just going through different stages of your Christian walk. I think of it as my last daughter is now going to college. She said, "Mom, are you going to be so sad when I'm gone?" And I thought, well, Chicago is a long way from California. However, I'm used to you going through different stages of life. I'm used to you going from a bottle to a cup. I'm used to you getting out of diapers to go to that next stage. I was comfortable when you finally went to kindergarten. And it's the same thing with the Lord. He wants us to grow up. So just remember, He will never leave you nor forsake you. He's always with you. You just might be growing up into a new stage of life. God bless you, and thank you for listening to Daily Disciples Devos.
Hi, this is Bobbye Brooks. I want to thank you for being here at the Power of Love Women's Conference. And it's not just for one day. We would love to keep in touch with you. So you'll notice in your program that you received a little card that says, "Keep in touch." And there's a few questions on the front and the back. And it's an optional, you know, it's up to you if you would like to receive our daily devotions, newsletters, and, you know, your name and email address. Again, we would love to be able to stay in touch with you and engage with you. And all of this can come right to your email. And we never, ever sell or give away your personal information. Flip it over to the backside, and there's some great information about Media for Women. Are you interested in starting a business or writing a book? If there's anything that God has put on your heart, and you know He's leading you to go that next step, but you just don't know how, we want to be that resource for you. So mediaforwomen.com is the website. We've started this company to help you. So if you just flip it over and keep in touch with us, check out Media for Women. Click the box that says interested in business or book publishing, and just let us know. We'll contact you and even set up a free consultation. So don't forget, fill out the Keep in Touch cards and be sure to turn those in at the Daily Disciples resource table or any of the Daily Disciples volunteers around the event. Again, thanks for being here, and we do hope to keep in touch with you. Hi, I'm Bobbye Brooks from Daily Disciples Ministries with today's devotional from the book of James, chapter 3, verse 1. "My friends, we should not all try to become teachers. In fact, teachers will be judged more strictly than others. All of us do many wrong things, but if you can control your tongue, you are mature and able to control your whole body. So isn't it interesting how those two verses go together? How many of you today would like to be a teacher or someone that, you know, teaches the Bible or Bible studies or even children? But think about how he says, but you must control your tongue. So when we speak, even teaching the Bible and the Word of God, whether it's to children or to adults, our bodies react to what we say. So think positively, think on the Word of God, and make sure that you pray ahead of time before you say anything, because that truly is the wisdom of God. For more information and more devotionals, go to dailydisciples.org.
And now, please give a warm welcome to Bobbye and Tonilee.